Good stuff. Today we talk about the cruise ship Crew Bar. My guest is Sarah Jones, Chief Security Officer at the ComC Cruise Line.
Hello.
Sarah, how do you see a crew bar at the cruise ship?
The crew bar is basically the only place at the cruise ship where you can breathe as a person. Of course, there is crew mess, but after you finish your meal, they want you out of there. If you smoke, there are very few designated smoking areas at the ship, all of them surrounded with steel walls and bulkheads. That's why crew goes to crew bar. Then, if you have time off, and just want to talk to somebody, there is a good chance that your roommate sleeps. If you go outside of your cabin, your voice could be heard all along the corridor, and it will bother day sleepers.
What about cabin parties and corridor parties I've heard of?
All cruise ships have security staff patrols. Remember, security staff is not on board to party. If they catch somebody drunk, they will report him, and he will be sent home next morning. If crew gets fired, that means that security staff is doing their jobs well.
What's the legal limit of alcohol and blood at the ship?
If you drink 2 beers, you're over the limit. The thing is, I can walk into the crew bar at midnight, test 10 people for intoxication, and 8 of them will be over the limit. But we don't do that. We wait for somebody to cross the line, because as soon as he is tested for alcohol intoxication, he is done for.
Some people would call that very flexible.
The law is the law. We must follow it. On paper. In reality, we don't want to fire 10 people per day. Even the captain knows, whoever works hard, he tends to play hard too. Since the alcohol is cheap, and entertainment options limited, we all go with the flow.
How does it look when you fire someone?
Typically, if someone is intoxicated and making trouble somewhere, I will get a telephone call from the scene. He will be reported by someone who doesn't like him. Right there, if I know the person, and know him to be good worker, I will call his friends to take care of him. Because if I go there, I'll do what I have to do, and he will get fired. At the other hand, if I hear that someone who I don't like is causing trouble somewhere, I'll be there with alcohol testing device in a matter of minutes. That's just how it goes.
So people tend to be nice to security staff.
As a security staff, I have access to all ship's areas, and everybody is extra nice to me.
The alcohol is very popular on cruise ships.
It's cheap and available. Working Saturdays and Sundays accumulates stress. Crew works very hard, and in the evening, many of them use alcohol as a sedative. They don't want to wait until they fall asleep. They want to black out and pass out as soon as their heads touch the pillow.
There you have it. Drink freely, but keep a low profile. And be extra nice to security.